way. In the same way, we can see and understand only a little about God now. Or another way it says this, it says, for now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know even as I am known. What will you know? You will know the God that you do not know yet. You will know the God that you do not know yet. You will know the God that you only knew, the God that you only knew as a child, because I'm going to give you a God of your maturity. You know there's a God of your maturity? Can anybody say amen to that? There's a God of your maturity. And you know how God grows you up? He grows you up through the fire, man. Fire grows you up. It said of Paul, it said he was given the greatest revelation. You know what went hand in hand with that? He suffered more than any other possible disciple. And many times he said, God, take this from me. And God said, I will not. I will not take this hard life from you. My grace is sufficient for you. Hand in hand with this great revelation is a hard life. And I guess that's how we find God. And that's how we demonstrate him. And that's how we lay down our lives. Right? Yeah. Uh-huh. You see, the God of your maturity is not the same God of your childhood. There's a God that you don't know yet. There's a God that the world does not know yet. I know the world doesn't know him yet because you didn't tell them about him yet. You don't know him yet. You can't tell the world about a God you don't know. He's going to show you who he really is. And it was Paul's life. He circled the world four times over to tell them about the God they did not know yet. And then he demonstrated with power. What power? Raising the dead? No, the power of letting the prison doors be shut on him and say, no, I'll be imprisoned if it'll touch you somehow. I'll endure injustice if somehow it'll save you. I won't think of myself, but I'll think of you. Life is greater. Amen. Praise the Lord. So with that, let me just close with these three figures of the Bible, because I think we need three figures of the Bible. And a demonstration of the God that we don't know. And the first one I want to talk about is Jacob. Does everybody know the story? I'm not going to read it because I don't want to belabor the point. I just want to get right to the point. You kind of like that when, you know, we're almost over, right? Just get to the point. I will. Jacob. Everybody knows the story of Jacob's ladder, right? It's a Jacob. He was traveling through life, if you will. And it said one night he fell into a deep sleep and he had a dream. And in his dream he saw the ladder descend from heaven. Uh-huh. And it said he saw angels ascending and descending from earth to heaven. And it said when he woke up from the dream, it says in verse 16 of Genesis 28, just in case you want to know, it says, then Jacob woke up from his sleep and he said, surely the Lord is in this place. Surely the Lord is in this place. And he said, and I didn't know it. There was a God that he did not know. You know Jacob's changed name? His name was changed to Israel. Israel. Israel is not only the name of a nation, it's the name of a man who had 12 sons. One daughter. And Israel himself, he says, there is a God that I did not know. And God wants to wake you up from your sleep, awake. He wants to wake you up from your sleep, and he wants to show you the God that you do not know. He's a God that says, I'm with you, I'm among you, I'm all around you, and you don't know it. You don't know it. I'm the God of your fathers and your children. He says, I'm the God of Abraham and Isaac. He says, I'm also the God of your descendants. I'm the God of everything and everyone, and you don't know it. He says, I am so much God, and you don't know it. I'm in charge of the whole world, and you don't know it. If you knew this God, you would not have 1 ounce of concern or worry. Your heart would probably break, but you wouldn't have an anxious thought. You'd break out of love and humility, out of empathy. There's a God that you don't know, and the God that I don't know, most of the times during my Monday through Friday, the God that I don't know, it's the God who absolutely is in charge of the world and everything in it, and he causes everything to happen at all times. The God that you don't know. The second figure I want to talk about is Moses. You guys know Moses from a baby. He was taught from a baby Remember, he went into that river, and Pharaoh's daughter found her, but his mom came and nursed him. And he was raised knowing he wasn't Hebrew. He was raised knowing the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. But there was a God that he did not know yet, and there was one day he was walking on the backside of the mountain in the desert, if you will, and he saw the burning bush upon the mountain, and he was drawn to the burning bush. You guys know the story? And as he was talking with the burning bush, God said, I want to use you. I want you to go to the children of Israel. I want you to tell them about the God that they don't know. And Moses said, well, I don't even know you. I don't know you. He said, what's your name? How about that? He didn't even know God's name. I don't know you. How can I save a nation? This man of God, of humility. He said, God, I don't know you. I don't know your name. And he said, God, what's your name? What's your name? And what did God say? I am that I am. Tell them that I am that I am sent you. I don't know what the greatest things Moses did, the 10 plagues or him admitting he didn't know God and was willing to throw away what he had to get something that he didn't have. I believe it began on the mountain when he said, God, I don't know you. Teach me who you are. And I will do what you've called me to do. I will live this life. And he lived quite the extraordinary life, didn't he? But he had to discover the God who he did not know yet. And lastly, you know the story of Paul. We talked about him, right? Before Paul became a Christian, he was on a road to Damascus. Does everybody know about the road to Damascus experience? He was on his way to Damascus. What was he going to do at Damascus? He was going to persecute the Christians. He had authority from the church. He was allowed to go find out who a Christian was, beat them, and throw them in jail. That's what he's going to do. But on his road to Damascus, it says he saw a great light and he was thrown from his horse. And there was a voice from heaven that said, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And Saul said, persecute you? I don't know you. Who are you? Who are you? Now, you know who Paul was? Paul was the greatest religious leader of the day. He was the greatest, right? Have you read his credentials? He was a Pharisee of Pharisees, smartest, best, the greatest religious leader. And what did he say? Who are you, God? In his religion, he didn't know who God was. And you know what? You know how God revealed himself? He didn't say, I am that I am. He didn't say all of the powerful things. He said, I am Jesus. Why? Because Jesus is the humble man that walked the earth, who was tried and found guilty as an innocent man, who was beaten and died upon a cross. And he said, this is your powerful God. This is your powerful God, Jesus. I am Jesus. Whom you persecute. I am Jesus. I am the God of heaven and earth. I am the one who lets you persecute me. I am the one that can cause your life to exist no more with the blink of an eye, but rather I allow you to persecute me. I allow you to throw your stones at my disciples and kill them. I am a God that you do not know. Because a God that you know would not allow that to happen. You thought you served the God and you had the power to take life. He says, I am the God that lays the lives down. I am the God of heaven and earth that allows you to persecute me, that allows you to beat me, that allows you to imprison me. You don't know. You don't know who I am. And he said, Paul, I'm going to show you a God that nobody on earth knows. And I want you to tell the world. I want you to tell the world. God says, I want to show you a God that you don't know yet. And that applies to all of us in the room And I have a special message to the young ones in the room. Maybe you're the Paul. Maybe you're the Jacob. Maybe you're the Moses. And God's going to show you a God that the whole world does not know. And then he says, go tell the world. Because man will not teach you. And I would say this with absolute love for my parents and my grandparents. Your parents will not teach you who this God is. Nor your grandparents. God himself will reveal himself to you. And amen. Thanks, Bob. And I say that because I was raised properly. I was raised to trust God and know him. I was raised to say, whatever you see, trust what you see, believe it. And I say that to the youth, but I also say it to everyone in the room. Maybe you're the one. You are the one. And he says, I want you to have your Damascus Road experience. I want to have your Jacob's Ladder experience, your burning bush experience. Why don't you look for it? Why don't you look for it? Or if you don't look for it, it's okay. You're going to walk by that burning bush. You're going to be drawn to it. You really have no choice in the matter, but it's nice to think that you do. And God is causing us and calling us to know the God. Are you ready, everybody? Are you ready? Yeah, yes and no. The God that you do not know yet. Amen. The word of the Lord, everybody. God bless you. Praise and worship team. Let us worship the Lord. Let's stand, everyone.